from here. And here we have rockets. And it's no wonder, because the polar orbit is right above us. Shortcut.
1962.
Okay.
That's how long it's been since we launched the first rocket. Here, on Andøya. That's long before my time. So, we can't just give up now. Did you know that Norway is represented in space with an incredible amount of technology? We made it possible to look underground, searching for water on Mars. We already deliver a lot to NASA and ESA.
Have you ever wondered what is going to happen if all these satellites suddenly get destroyed? What happens then? Aerospace technology is only becoming more important. So the more we can do, and the more we can do ourselves, the more equipped we are for the future.
When we eventually conquer and expand into space, we can't rely on resources from Earth. We've already used them up. We'll need to find and extract metals and other resources. So it's important to not end up at the back of the queue. In Norway, we've never been satisfied with being last. We'll do what we always do. Go first.
Space technology offers incredible opportunities. We in Norway are keen to share and take care of everyone. But not everybody is. That's why we have a responsibility to ensure that this does not fall into the wrong hands.
I hear the grown-ups saying we're a bit slow here in Norway, but I don't believe that. We're tough bastards, and we can turn on a dime if we need to. And now it's needed. The clock is ticking.
The most important reason Andøya needs to be the next hub for the space industry is us.
Gabriel, Isfrid, Erika, and me. You can't give away our opportunity for a better future to some fucking idiot who doesn't take care of it.